Are you ready? Are you ready?
Hello everyone, this is Esther, aka Glam Lady One. How are you? I just wanted to make a video today about something that's very near and dear to my heart, which is weight loss and fitness or anything like that. I just thought that I wanted to share my experience about concerning losing weight and exercising and things like that. I'm right now, and the holidays are such a challenging time for us to maintain our weight if we're at a good weight, or to avoid gaining weight. That is like the biggest problem. So I know that as we're coming to the new year, a lot of you are going to be making New Year's resolutions, and the primary one is going to be wanting to lose weight if you need to do that. So I just wanted to share with you something about myself. Back in 2006, I made the decision to change my lifestyle basically and take my weight off once and for all. I was literally 110 pounds heavier. Yes, 110 pounds, basically a whole person heavier if you're talking about like a teenager or something. And I did not like how I looked. I did not like how I felt. I felt like a stranger in my own body. I couldn't breathe right. I had aches and pains. Have to do is make a decision to change your weight. You have to go at it wholeheartedly. Don't say, oh, I really need to get this weight off. I really need to do something about this. No. Wholeheartedly, I'm getting this weight off. I'm sick of looking like this. I'm sick of feeling like this. And I'm doing something about it. Enough is enough. Secondly, set realistic goals. Ladies, I cannot stress to you enough that it takes time to lose weight. It took me a year to lose my 110 pounds. A year, maybe a year and a month, 13 months. I did not put that weight on overnight, and I didn't expect for it to come off overnight. I don't care if I was losing 1 pound a week. As long as that scale was steadily going down, I was going to continue with what I was doing. So set realistic goals. You're not going to lose 100 pounds in 30 days. It's just not going to happen, unless you maybe you get bypass surgery, which, you know, if that's your thing, that's your thing. Third, do not say you're going to diet, because a diet implies a temporary fix. Basically, you're going to change the way you eat for a period of time till you get your weight off, and then you're going to be like, ah, I did it. Now I can eat. No, you don't want to do that. What you want to do is make a lifestyle change. Literally change the choices of the foods. Basically, if you like chicken, there's nothing wrong with that. But don't get fried chicken every time. Don't get chicken smothered in gravy every time. Get baked chicken, grilled chicken. When you go to fast food restaurants, instead of buying that cheeseburger, hamburger, Big Mac, whatever, you get something like a grilled chicken sandwich. Substitute a salad for fries. Get a fruit cup. Instead of getting that high-calorie, sugary soda, get a water, or even get something light. Nothing wrong with drinking water. And that's going to lead me to my fourth tip. Drink plenty of water. Ladies, I just cannot stress to you enough, hydrate, hydrate, hydrate. Your liver, the purpose of your liver is to help with metabolism. Well, if you're not drinking enough water so that your kidneys can effectively cleanse your bloodstream and filter out the impurities, your liver has to take over. So guess what? If your liver is trying to help your kidneys eliminate waste, it is not fully focused 100% on your metabolism, burning up those excess calories. So please drink plenty of water. Last but not least is please, ladies, exercise. You cannot don't exercise as well. The change in eating and the exercise, they go hand in hand. One without the other is not going to work. So exercise. I exercised in the initial phases of my weight loss. I exercised 6 days a week. Yes, 6 days a week for an hour and a half to 2 hours a day. I did. I did it after work. I didn't stop and think about it. I got home. I freshened up. I changed my clothes and I went to the gym. Period. There was no options there. I don't care if it was raining. I don't care if it was snowing. I didn't care. I'm getting my workout in. I figured if I ate today, then I could work out today. That was my motto. Find something that you like, though. I don't want people to feel like exercise has to be absolutely miserable and tedious. Getting on a treadmill. Find things that you like to do. What personally would work for me is dancing. I absolutely love to dance. I used to dance in high school. I drop it low. I love dancing. So what I did is I found something called a hip-hop cardio jam class at my local YMCA. I did that about four days a week, and the other 2 days a week I did step classes, you know, with the risers and things that you do step, and I would do kickboxing. But my primary exercise was the hip hop cardio. I love it. And the remainder of my weight I took off doing Zumba. I know everyone has seen the commercials with Beto Perez about the Zumba fitness and your wiggling and shaking. Ladies, I am here to tell you that it really works. I absolutely love it. It's high energy. You're dancing. You're shaking. It doesn't even feel like exercise because you're having so much fun. The music is so hype. I mean, I just absolutely love it. So that is my thing. I love to dance. So I worked in what I love to do and worked that into a fitness regimen. So find something you like. Maybe that dancing isn't your thing. Try walking, running, swimming, bicycling. And also you might want to incorporate weightlifting. I'm doing that now. I weightlift about 3 days a week along with my cardio, which is 5 days a week. That helps to tone and also helps you build more calories so that when you're done, you don't have so much loose skin if you have a lot of weight to lose. So, that is all that I can think of for today. Just 5 tips. Feel free to inbox me, message me. I would love to help you if you have any questions, if there's any encouragement I can give you. Nothing feels so good as to lose weight and realize that everything is getting too big, that you actually have to go buy new clothes. They're not getting too small. So ladies, I just wish all of you good luck with your weight loss goals, your weight loss journey. Nothing tastes as good as being thin filled. Take care and see you next time. Bye-bye. Days when I had a Mustang and now